What is about to happen to Bitcoin and the stock market? Well, why don't we ask Jim and see what Jim has to say. What do you think, buddy? He says, sell, sell, sell. Okay. Well, let me offer you a test question. Do you remember hearing this? Be fearful when others are greedy and greedy when others are fearful. And actually, I did not know he said this one. If you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. Warren Buffett. So let's use his principles and go, oh, maybe I could be. Well, technicals say sell. All right. Chart, we don't know yet. Let's just pretend we don't understand charts at Bitcoin at $35,826. But at the end of the day, let's come over here and see. Now, definitely, he's not going to recommend that you buy Bitcoin because he just wouldn't. I don't know if it's him or Charlie Munger that said it's comparable to rat poison. I don't know. I've never tried rat poison. But right now, when it comes to Bitcoin, if you are just going by the narrative, you are in extreme fear. And if you want to know what the stock market is right now, it's this emoji con. It's this guy right here. Do I need to come over here? It's this one. I don't know. We're right. But a week ago, we had fear. And hopefully in this video, I will provide you with some fors and against on both sides of it. I want you guys to be able to make up your own decisions. Bitcoin crypto gets a little bit more difficult because swing trading, you can blindfold me. I can swing trade all day long. Trying to swing trade crypto, a completely whole nother beast with a whole nother charts that we have to look at. And not just charts, but like, where is the money moving? And I've showed you this from CryptoQuant before. Whenever you see a big dump or a movement, it's like, look out, something's gonna happen. And Fuabamo right over here, right? Yep. And then the sell-off. So this could be signaling to you, we're getting close to a bottom, but there's more. Our last movement, right there on Glassnode. This was saying, hey, I think we've reached a bottom, which actually, I should probably turn myself off for this one. Do you guys see this? And then the big sell-off, right? Same thing. We had a sell-off and now, look where we're at. We're all the way down here. So could the sell-off finally be over? And the answer is no. And also people have been asking me in the comment section, we're in a bear market. We are in a bear market. Bravo, look at the daily. We're underneath the 200. That clearly signals bear market. Oh, look, we're underneath the 50. Clearly. Also, we drop more than 50%. We have to be in a bear market. And the answer is not yet. Just because something moves 55%, is that what we did? Was it a 54%, 60%? That does not, just because you have one arbitrary number, it's like, oh, we are definitely in a bear market. No, there is a whole, let's take a look at the weekly. Are we in a bear market in the weekly? The answer is no, but I don't want to look at it on the weekly. I want to take a measurement on the gains. We're either going up to 50, or we are going down, down, down. Where are we going down? In the 23. But if you were to listen to Warren Buffett's advice, people are scared. So I guess this is the time to buy? Or no, do we need to look at technicals and go, we need to wait? How about if we wait for confirmation? Then we buy. And if you were a swing trader and you were swing trading this, you would have been out a whole long time ago. But if you are a buy and holder, and it's frustrating too, because it's like, well, what do we do? I don't want to wait. I want to make trades right now. Well, there's a plethora of stock market to be had Mondays through Fridays, closed on the weekends. And what you do is you get involved in my course, you learn about it, and then you can do this all day long. And I will leave a link in the description for 70-ish off percent on my trading course if you would like to take a little peekster. Or you could just follow the news and just try to figure it out. Like, what's going on? Bitcoin drops. Oh, Why'd it drop? Amid Weibo crypto suspension. So that's why it dropped. Goldman CEO survey. Largest cryptocurrency is sitting near its 20-day average. And I do like that they do use some technicals, even though that might confuse some humans. And I don't talk too much about the 20, but as you can see here, we are currently below the 20, and we are currently below the 200. So what Bitcoin needs to do right about now is get its act together. And actually, on this channel, I use the 13, 21, and 34 because they are Fibonacci numbers. And for some weird reason, Bitcoin, stocks, things just travel in that Fibonacci. Looking at that, we are also underneath those pretty colors too. And I will tell you, actually I'll show you, if you change this to, if you're new, change it to Heikinashi. You can kind of get a better understanding of where we're moving. And I'll tell you, in this area, it's like, we don't know, we're waiting. Maybe you could have over the next day or two a little pump. Bitcoin usually breaks out ahead of any kind of formation. And I would not be surprised within the next 24 hours also. I think the bulls are starting to get a little worn, right? You're like, whew, this is getting exhausting. The volume is super light. So this right there can be pushed pretty easily. Also, a ton of accumulation in this area. A whole lot. Not so much down here. Some more up here. A lot of accumulation. That's why it's the probabilities too. Do you see back up there or down there? It's going to cut through that area. Yeah, is my head in the way? No, I'm okay. It'll cut through that like butter. And even without the VPVR, you guys can see there's not that much support, not too much price action in this. So, yeah, do not be surprised. But coming in from the good news, life-changing, El Salvador looks to become the world's first country to adopt Bitcoin as a legal tender. And I will tell you, people in China, people trying to protect their wealth or trying to move their wealth. And you can't really, like gold, gold's great, gold and silver, but you can kind of get caught. I mean, imagine leaving China with $1 million worth of gold, $10 million worth of gold. You're going to get caught. Now, Bitcoin, a whole lot different, right? You could actually create an account, or you could have something like my Exodus wallet. I have an Exodus wallet, and I could, memorize my passcode, my key, my private keys, and I can remember it. And then when I get wherever I get, I log back in and voila, $12 billion. And it's usually 12 words and that's it. So you remember your 12 words and you get to keep your money. You forget one of those words, you get to lose your money. But at the end of the day, whether we are in a bull market or bear market, Bitcoin's not going to go away, and countries are going to have to deal with it. And especially like countries like the United States of America, where we have just gone a little crazy, right? As the world reserve currency, it's kind of been a party over here. It's like being on Oprah. You get a million, you get a million, everyone gets a million. So how long will this party last for America? Well, I think we're coming to a close. Even though people like this, you don't see her yet, but I can show her to you. See it? A cutie. Higher interest rates would be good for the country. Oh, yeah, absolutely. That's what I've been looking for quite a long time. I'm sure that would be great, Janet. I think people will definitely borrow more because that's where money is created, is in the banking system. With higher interest rates? Sure. That would do wonders for the housing market. That would do wonders for the stock market. But I believe you are not telling the truth. And quote, if we ended up with a slightly higher interest rate environment, it would actually be a plus for society's point of view and the Fed's point of view. And you know what? Part of me says, yes, absolutely. Let's have hard money and let's have an interest rate environment that is normal. But you're not going to see that. Let everything be more so a free market and let's just work this thing out. But these people will not like the downside to said free market and let's just figure this thing out. Or as some would say, let the chips fall where the chips will fall. Oh no, they're holding all the chips and the dip. And then I come along and say, buy those chips and buy those dips. Because when you have stocks like AMC, and in this kind of environment that the Fed has painted us all into, this is what happens when we have a system like we do, where all of a sudden you're like, oh, wow, you know, my house just shot up by $1 million. Meme stocks could spark more heat in the week ahead as investors await inflation news. And I say, no, Patty Doom or Dome, they're not waiting for that. You're waiting on that swing trade. Like on GameStop, are we going to see a reversal on GME? And hey, look, I have a drawing all drawn for you. Well, that's a shocker. We broke out of that. That was a nice bull pennant you drew there. Bravo, and I don't think my lines because I'm still on the Heikinashi. We gotta change it up a little bit. And actually on GameStop on the 1 hour, oh, look, are we gonna break? Are you gonna wait for confirmation? We may have another buy. But not if Morgan Stanley has their way. A reset is required. Huh, why Morgan Stanley sees pain in the next 6 months. So let's just see where we end up going. But at the end of the day, I hope it's volatile. I hope we have those beatdowns so we can get in on those reversals, take some cheddar off the table. And then with that cheddar, we can do something like start a business, like Stonks to the Moon. Look at this. We can write a book, a kid's book, on how to make it to the moon on stocks. Oh, I'm sorry, Professor Clark. That would be on Stonks. And let's do this. What is your guess? How much do you think Professor Clark, author of Stonks to the Moon, makes on a paperback book. I'm going to guess 22,000. And oh my gosh, I got it right on the dot. Maybe that's because I cheated. Sorry, I had it before you. $22,418. And hey, didn't I say at the beginning of the video, I would tie this in. If you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. And I would say that's some pretty darn good advice. That is called passive income. This guy right here, Stonks to the Moon. He makes passive income while he's sleeping. People give him $22,000 every single month. I, on YouTube, passive income. I have products on Amazon. I have products off Amazon. I have digital products, all passive income. And I probably disagree with Warren more times than I agree with him, but those are two really good quotes, also right here, $997. But for you, a deep discount, I don't know, what is it, $297, something like that? I think you'll be pleasantly surprised when you click on the link and you see my discount. Also, there's two free ones up there. It's almost an hour long of videos on selling on Amazon and finding a product so you can go, oh my gosh, this actually works, so I can be like Warren Buffett. I could trade stocks, take that money, hire someone to publish a book on it. You could do self-publishing, but you guys get it, right? I also leave a link for both courses together for like $400 and something. That's a steal. But what's even more of a steal is if you actually do it, like, right? You actually steal it and you do it. And then you go, hey, I'm sleeping at night. I have passive income. If I want to trade stonks, I can trade stonks. If I want to do another place an order on Amazon, I click the button. Oh, that wasn't too hard now, was it? If you want to write another book, things that you're passionate about, you can do it. Or you could just work your entire life and then die. I hope you don't. It's such a limited amount of time. And this is your life. Let's make some changes. And I'll see you tomorrow.